Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The Surah Al Kahf, verses from 9 to 26, with its translation and short explanation. A'uzu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Am hasibta anna ashabal kahf wal raqim kanu min ayatina ajaba. إِذَا وَالْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا فَضُرِبْنَا عَلَى آذَانِهِمْ فِي الْكَهْفِ سِنِينَ عَدَدًا ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ لِنَعْلَمَ أَيُّ الْحِزْبَيْنِ أَحْصَى لِمَا لَبِثُوا أَمَدًا نحن نقص عليك نبأهم بالحق إنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزدناهم هدى وربطنا على قلوبهم إذ قاموا فقالوا ربنا رب السماوات والأرض لن ندعو من دونه إلها لقد قلنا إذا شتتا هؤلاء قومنا اتخذوا من دونه آلهة لولا يأتون عليهم بسلطان بين فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا وإذ اعتزلتموهم وما يعبدون إلا الله فأووا إلى الكهف ينشر لكم ربكم من رحمته ويهيئ لكم من أمركم مرفقا The verse number 9, the story of the Ashabi Kahf starts here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Do you consider the sleepers of the cave and the wearers of the inscription to be among our strange signs? When those few young men took refuge in the cave, they said, Our Lord, have a special mercy on us from thyself and guide us out of our ordeal and guide us out of our ordeal aright. Accordingly, we lulled them to a deep sleep in the cave for a number of years. Then we raised them up in order to test which of them were able to calculate correctly the period of their stay there. In the first verse, that means the verse number 9, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking a question. Do you consider the sleepers of the cave and the bearers of the inscription to be among our strange signs? This question is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that in this universe there are greater signs of the greatness of Allah than this story. And we pass on these signs of the creation of Allah day and night, so we must ponder on them. For example, the creation of the heaven and that of the earth, the oceans, the mountains, the day and night, the regular succession of the day and night, and many, many signs are great signs. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that keeping some people sleeping in the cave for more than 300 years and then making them awake again, this is not difficult for Allah. This is not a sign greater than the other signs that we see day and night. Here also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word inscription. That means the memorial which was later on fixed there in the name of those sleepers of the cave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that those people, when they took refuge in the cave and they prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, you bestow your special mercy on us and make our affairs easy for us and guide us on the right way. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them sleep deeply in the cave. and they remained sleeping for hundreds of years, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them wake up so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may see which one of them knows the exact time, the correct period of their sleeping. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Now we tell you their real story. They were a few young men who believed in their Lord, and we increased them in their guidance. We strengthened their hearts when they rose up, and they declared, 'Our Lord is the one who is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. We will not invoke any other deity than Him. It will be the most improper thing if we do so.' Then they held mutual consultation, saying, 'These people of ours have given up the Lord of the universe and adopted other deities. Why do they not bring forward any clear argument in support of their creed? Well, who can be more wicked than the one who forges a lie against Allah? Now that you have forsaken them and discarded the deities they worship besides Allah, let us go to such and such a cave for refuge. Your Lord will extend to you His mercy and order your affairs for you for the best.'" So up to here is the story before their sleeping. I will give a short explanation of these verses. These were the true followers of Isa alayhi salam, according to the commentary of this Quranic statement. And they lived in a place, the city name was Ephesus. It was in Minor Asia, in the Roman Empire. All people were Christians, but an emperor came who was very cruel, and he was forcing and persecuting people to become polytheists and worship an idol. He had fixed for them an idol, a false deity. These seven people, they didn't obey him, and when the emperor knew about their disobedience, he called them up and he ordered them to worship the idol. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah had given them, they were guided people, they believed in their Lord, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had increased them in their guidance. And when the emperor ordered them to worship the idol, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthened their hearts. So they rose up and they declared that our Lord is the one who is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. And we will not worship any other deity other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we do that, that will be a very, very big sin. So we will not do it. The emperor became very angry. He threatened them to kill them, that they will be killed. But then he gave them 3 days' time and advised them to think about this matter and come after 3 days. And then if they don't obey him, he would kill them. They went away and they took advantage of these 3 days' time. They did mutual consultation among themselves, and they said that as we have left them, discarded them and their deities, the deities which they are worshipping, so let us go to take refuge in a cave. Let us go to the mountains. They said that these people, they have left the Lord of the universe and they are worshipping other deities, and they have no clear argument, no clear proof for their belief, for their faith. And they said that who can be more wicked than the one who invents lie against Allah, because Allah is one single and unique God, and there is no other deity besides Him. So anyone who worship another deity or forces someone to worship another deity, he actually invents and forges lies against Allah, and that is the most wicked person. So they said to each other that now that you have forsaken them and discarded the deities they worship besides Allah, let us go to such and such cave for refuge. And then they in all their very hard circumstances, they trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said, your Lord will extend to you His mercy and order your affairs for you for the best. And in this is a lesson for us all Muslims, that we also should do like that. This surah Al-Kahf was revealed in this third stage of the Meccan life, when the Muslims were suffering at the hands of the polytheists. So there is a lesson for the Muslims that look at these people, the sleepers of the cave. They faced all their trouble and they left this worldly life and they went to take refuge in the cave, and they trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the things easy for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them sleep for more than 300 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them a sign for all the coming races. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ عَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَإِذَا غَرَبَتْ تَقْرِضُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَهُمْ فِي فَجْوَةٍ مِّنْهُ ذَلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ وَمَنْ يُدْلِلْ فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُ وَلِيًّا مُرْشِدًا وَتَحْسَبُوهُمْ أَيْقَاظًا وَهُمْ رُقُودٌ وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِطٌ ذِرَاعَيْهِ بِالْوَسِيدِ لَوِ اطَّلَعْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ لَوَلَّيْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِرَارًا وَلَمُلِئْتَ مِنْهُمْ رُعْبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, as they went to the cave, they were tired, they slept there. Then what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ عَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَإِذَا غَرَبَتْ تَقْرِضُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. If you had looked at them in the cave, it would have appeared to you that when the sun rose, it left the cave to one side and inclined towards the right, and when it set, it turned away from them and went to the left while they lay in the spacious place inside the cave. That means the entrance of their cave was towards the north. So the sun, while rising and setting, was passing from on one side and on the other side in a way that the sun was not entering the cave. Therefore, there was darkness and also there was cool, and people from outside couldn't see them as they were lying in the cave. This was one of the signs of Allah. Whomsoever Allah guides aright, he is guided aright, and whomsoever Allah lets go astray, you will find no guardian to direct him. So this setting and rising of the sun and passing from this on this side and the other side of the entrance of the cave and not entering the cave, and the people sleeping in the cave for more than hundreds of years, this was one of the signs of Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those whom Allah guides aright, then they are guided aright. And those whom Allah makes astray, you will not find any guardian for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at such occasions says that Allah is the all-knowing, the wise. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. So whenever we turn to Allah, any person who turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him. And if a person doesn't turn to Allah and chooses the wrong way, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will let him go astray. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَحْسَبُهُمْ أَعْقَازُهُمْ وَهُمْ رُقُودٌ وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِطٌ ذِرَاعَيْهِ بِالْوَسِيدِ لَوِ اطَّلَعْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ لَوَلَّيْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِرَارًا وَلَمُلِئْتَ مِنْهُمْ رُعْبًا. If you had seen them, it would have appeared to you as if they were awake, whereas in fact they were asleep. We turned them about to the right and the left sides. We turned them about to the right and the left sides, and their dog was sitting at the entrance of the cave without outstretched forelegs. If you had looked at them, you would have turned on your heels, and their sight would have struck you with terror. Now, as they were sleeping, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their sleep were turning them from one side to the other side, like we turn during our sleep. Moreover, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if any person had tried to look inside the cave, he would think that they were awake, because they were turning from right side to the left side. A person would think they were awake, but actually they were asleep. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if any person had tried to enter the cave or look at them from the entrance of the cave, they would be struck with terror, and they would run away. In this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept them asleep and kept them safe from all people for hundreds of years. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them wake up. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ لِيَتَسَاءَلُوا بَيْنَهُمْ قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ قَالُوا رَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا لَبِثْتُمْ فَابْعَثُوا أَحَدَكُمْ بِوَرِقِكُمْ هَٰذِهِ إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَيُّهَا أَزْكَى طَعَامًا فَلْيَأْتِكُمْ بِرِزْقٍ مِّنْهُ وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ وَلَا يُشْعِرَنَّ بِكُمْ أَحَدًا إِنَّهُمْ إِنْ يَظْهَرُوا عَلَيْكُمْ يَرْجُمُوكُمْ أَوْ يُعِيدُوكُمْ فِي مِلَّتِهِمْ وَلَنْ تُفْلِحُوا إِذًا أَبَدًا وَكَذَلِكَ عَاثَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا إِذْ يَتَنَازَعُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَمْرَهُمْ فَقَالُوا ابْنُوا عَلَيْهِمْ بُنْيَانًا رَبُّهُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِهِمْ قال الذين غلبوا على امرهم لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and in the same miraculous way we raised them up again, so that they may ask one another about their wonderful experience. One of them asked, well, how long have you remained in this condition? that is in this condition of sleep? The others answered, maybe we have remained so for a day or a part of a day. Then they declared, your Lord knows best how long we have remained in this condition. So let us send one of us with this silver coin to the city, and he should look for a place wherein he can get the best food, the halal food, clean food, so that he may bring something to eat. He should, however, conduct himself with caution, lest anyone should discover our whereabouts. For if they succeed in overpowering us, they will surely stone us to death or force us back into their faith. And in that case, we will never be able to obtain true prosperity. In this way, we revealed, Allah SWT says, in this way, we revealed their secret to the people of the city, so that they should know that Allah's promise is true and that there is no doubt about the coming of the hour of resurrection. But it is a pity that instead of considering this aspect of the matter, they were at that time disputing among themselves with regard to them, that is, with regard to the sleepers of the cave. Some of them said, let us build a wall against them, for their Lord alone knows best about them. But those people who prevailed in their matter said, we will build a place of worship as a memorial for them. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the time when they were raised again, when they woke up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same miraculous way made them wake up. They were having the same health, the same shape, the same clothes. They had no dehydration, they had no starvation. After 309 years, they woke up. And then they asked one another that how long you are sleeping. One of them said maybe for a day or less than a day, while the other said Allah knows best how long we remained sleeping. And then they gave a silver coin to one of them and they sent him to the city to bring some clean food, the best food for them to eat. But they advised him to be careful so that people shouldn't know their whereabouts. Actually, the king, the emperor, from whom they had fled away to take refuge in the cave, was a very cruel king, the emperor. And now they thought that it's the same time. They thought maybe yesterday we had come to the cave. So they said that if those people succeed in finding us, then they will stone us to death. Or they will force us to worship the idol, and in that case, we will not be able to get prosperity, because then we will go to hell. So as they felt hungry, and they sent one of their friends to the city to buy food, in this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in this way we revealed their secret to the people of the city. Now as this man went to a shop and bought some food. Well, the man was strange, his clothes were strange, his language. But in the end, when he presented that silver coin, it had the picture of that old emperor who had passed away about 300 years ago. Now the shopkeeper was surprised and he asked him, "Do you have an old treasure with you that you have got, brought this coin to me?" He said, "No, I don't have a treasure. This is my own money." Well, the shopkeeper couldn't believe him, and the argument started, and some people gathered there. And finally, this man, the sleeper, who was from the sleepers of the cave, he understood that actually that emperor has passed away, and these people are no more polytheists. They are Christians. They are the followers of Jesus, Isa alayhi salam. So he slowly told them that actually only yesterday, I and my six friends, we had left this city and we had went to the mountains to take refuge in a cave because of this emperor whose photo is on this coin, because he was forcing us to worship the idol, and we feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we refused that, and then he was going to kill us. Therefore, myself and my six friends, we went to the cave. Well, they, to confirm the truth, they followed him. Also, they called the ruler, the governor. He also came, and a large crowd followed this man because the story was very strange, because the coin had a photo of an emperor who had passed away about 300 years ago. So it was unbelievable to them. They followed him to the cave. There, his other friends came out and they said salam to them, to their Christian brothers. And when they came to know that they had been sleeping for more than 300 years, it was a very strange news to them. They entered the cave, they lay down, and they died. Allahu Akbar. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Now those people, when they saw this wonderful happening, actually they should have taken the lesson about the hour, about the resurrection, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said there, so that they should know that Allah's promise is true and that there is no doubt about the hour of resurrection. But people, you know, they are always misled by Satan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May we should always pray to Allah to give us refuge from Satan. Then those people, they went into dispute among themselves, the people of the city Ephesus. The righteous people from them who worshipped only single God Allah, they said that let us build a wall. Let us build a wall against them that is on the entrance of the cave, for their Lord alone knows best about them. We don't know who were they and how were they, so we should just make a wall on the cave and let them lying in the cave. While the other people, especially those who had authority, they said that we will build a place of worship as a memorial for them. So making the place of worship again, it was like an invitation for polytheism. These people who prevailed, they were from the Christians, from the followers of Isa alayhi salam, but they had gone astray, making the pictures of Isa alayhi salam and pictures of his mother, and making Isa alayhi salam the son of God. And in this way, as they had, they was already astray, so they decided to make a place of worship on this cave. So that then people would go there and, you know, and will worship them also, and and would ask prayers from them, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Here I must say that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam has strictly forbidden the building of a masjid on graves. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَيَقُولُونَ ثَلَاثَةٌ رَابِعُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ خَمْسَةٌ سَادِسُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ رَجْمًا بِالْغَيْبِ وَيَقُولُونَ سَبْعَةٌ وَثَامِنُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ قُلْ رَبِّي يَعْلَمُ بِعِدَّتِهِمْ مَا يَعْلَمُهُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ فَلَا تُمَارِ فِيهِمْ إِلَّا مِرَاءً ظَاهِرًا وَلَا تَسْتَفْتِ فِيهِمْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا ولا تقولن لشيء اني فاعل ذلك غدا الا ان يشاء الله واذكر ربك اذا نسيت وقل عسى ان يهديني ربي لاقرب من هذا رشدا ولبسوا في كهفهم 300 سنين وازدادوا 9 قل الله اعلم بما لبسوا له غيب السماوات والارض ابصر به واسمع ما لهم من دونه من ولي ولا يشركوا في حكمه أحدا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, some people will say they were 3 and the 4th was their dog. And some others will say they were 5 and the 6th was their dog. These are mere irrelevant guesses. There are still others who say they were 7 and the 8th was their dog. Say, my Lord alone, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam, my Lord alone knows best how many they were. There are a few people only who know their correct number. So you should not enter into discussions with them about their number except in a cursory way. Nor ask anyone about them, and never say about any matter that I will do this tomorrow without saying inshallah. For you cannot do anything except that Allah wills it. And if you forgot, and if you forget, then when you remember, then you should say that it may be that my Lord will guide me nearer to the right conduct than this. That means whenever you say I will do this thing tomorrow, you should say, inshallah, I will do it tomorrow. This is an admonition inside the story. Because we never know if we would be able to do the thing tomorrow. But we would be able to do the thing tomorrow only if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps us and Allah wills us to do that thing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you forgot to say inshallah, then when you remember, you should say, it may be that my Lord will guide me nearer to the right conduct than this. Alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in case of forgetfulness, again gives us a satisfactory words. Alhamdulillah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they remained in their cave for 300 years and add 9 more to them. That is 309 years they remained in the cave. A Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam say, Allah knows best about the period of their stay there, for He is fully aware of all that is hidden in the heavens and the earth. What an excellent seer and what an excellent hearer He is. There is no other guardian of the creation in the heaven and the earth, and he does not associate anyone with himself in this authority. Sadaqallahu al-Azim. This was the translation and also a little bit explanation of the story. This story also came in the history. Actually, in the beginning, we read that the polytheists, the idolaters of Mecca, they went to the Jews and asked them some questions to test Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Jews gave them these three questions, one about the story of the sleepers of the cave, one about Khizr alayhi salam, and one about Zulkarnain. As these stories, especially this the story of the sleepers of the cave, it was only present in the history of the Jews and Christians. And the Arab people, the people of Hijaz, they had no knowledge, no information about this story. So this was really a very good question to know if Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had an unseen source of knowledge, if he was really a prophet of God. Now, as these idolaters went to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him the questions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the stories in Surah Al-Kahf to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the knowledge in this Surah Al-Kahf that actually the idolaters of Mecca, their example was similar to the persecutor emperor of Ephesus, while the example of the sleepers of the cave, they were monotheists, they were the followers of Tawheed, their example was applicable to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers. So the way the sleepers of the cave were persecuted by the emperor of their time, the idolater emperor, at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the idolaters were persecuting and torturing Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told this story, but as I read in the commentary, that actually this story was present in the history of the Jews and Christians. How? This story happened in the city of Ephesus, that was a big city in the Roman Empire in Asia Minor, that means very near to Europe, which was far away from Hijaz and Mecca. And so in Hijaz and Mecca, there was no knowledge of the story. The story was written by a priest known as Gibbon. They said that there was an emperor. Actually, I am forgetting about the names of the emperors, but I'm just telling you shortly the story, that the emperor was a cruel one. He was forcing to turn people to polytheism. And these seven followers of Isa alayhi salam, they didn't obey him, and they decided to take refuge in the cave. And when they were going to the cave, on the way a dog also followed them. They tried to get rid of the dog, but the dog was following them. And finally, when they found the cave, a big vast cave, they entered the cave and the dog sat at the entrance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that with their dog sitting at the entrance with its outstretched legs. That means the dog also was there. Subhanallah, a great sign of Allah's greatness. Then hundreds of years passed, and that emperor passed away, and later on again Christianity prevailed in Ephesus. All people then followed the religion of Christianity, but they had dispute about the day of resurrection, and none of them was sure if this resurrection was a true thing to happen. While the emperor, the new emperor, he wanted that the people should believe in resurrection. And it is said in the commentary that actually that emperor prayed to God, "O God, bring a sign which will prove to these people the day of resurrection." And it was that time when those sleepers of the cave woke up. And so to the people it was proved that this is very easy for God, for the only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make people asleep for 309 years and then make them wake up in the same state as they had slept. If Allah can do that, then it is also very easy for Allah to bring the day of resurrection, the true hour of resurrection, and give us all a new life and account us. So this story happened, and then those people, they disputed together as the sleepers of the cave went in the cave and they died. Those people of the city Ephesus, some righteous ones said that make only a wall on the entrance of the cave, while the others, the strong powerful people, they said no, we will make a masjid, a place of worship on the cave. So they made a place of worship, and later on the ruins of those things were seen in that at the mountains near the city Ephesus. This was the story of the sleepers of the cave, and we are supposed to take a few lessons from it. Number one, the believers in any case shouldn't bow to falsehood, shouldn't bow to false deities. In all circumstances they must stand strong, even if they have to leave the city and go to the mountains, they should do that. But they must remain strong at their belief. Also, this is very easy for Allah to do things in the supernatural way. So it was easy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make them sleep and remain sleeping for more than 300 years and then wake them up again. And so we Muslims must also always trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all circumstances. And Allah can help the believers in any way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants it. We must believe in the day of resurrection, because this is the main lesson in this story. And then we must avoid making places of worship on the tombs or on the graves. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun alal mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun.